Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Ryan Specht. Today we're going to be taking a look at the ROCKWOOD Geo Pro 19FBS. Important things when you're looking for a new travel trailer is the weights. These ROCKWOOD Geo Pros are built for your smaller SUVs and smaller trucks to tow. Dry weight on this guy comes in just under 3,300 pounds. You're looking at a gross vehicle weight about 3,900 pounds. So really lots of options with different vehicles to tow this baby with. All right, time to come on inside and check out the interior features on this ROCKWOOD Geo Pro. For a little camper, boy, they pack a lot into it. As you look around, one of my favorite things you probably notice is the whitewashed walls and cabinetry. I think that's a really great feature, and something this size really helps it feel quite a bit bigger. So let's start here at the beginning. When you first come in, you've got your microwave as well as your refrigerator. This is a gas electric fridge. It does have a nice little freezer in it as well. So a pretty good amount of storage here for your cold beverages and food and things of that nature. Right here on the wall, as soon as you come in, is going to be your control panel. We'll have the buttons for your power awning, the small slide out that you've got, as well as controls for your water heater, your water pump, things of that nature. Right here, you've got a pretty good sized kitchen set up. So you got a nice glass cover over your cooktop that will also serve as the backsplash when it's time to cook. So you just fold this baby up and it'll kind of set up as the backsplash. Nice three burner range. Even though we're in a small unit, you still have a full size oven and cooktop. Look at this. 22 inches you've got your oven. Most of the industry only uses 17, so you're not cooking Thanksgiving dinner, but still a pretty good sized meal. And I do love the new glass front that they've got on it this season. Right above that, you've got your power fan on the hood. Does have a light on it as well, and this actually does exhaust out of the camper. Nice overhead cabinetry here, pretty good amount of storage. It goes about elbow deep above the cooktop and over above the sink as well. Also want to point out, it does have an onboard solar panel. So when we bring these in from the factory, there is a 100-watt flexible solar panel already on the roof. So that's just going to help maintain the trickle charge on the battery. And as we continue to rotate over, we'll go right to the entertainment center. So this is going to be a 12-volt TV, so this will run off your DC or your 12-volt battery system. Has a built-in DVD player on it. You've also got the indoor-outdoor speakers for the stereo. You got your speakers here as well as on the outside. It is a Bluetooth-capable stereo. Also has an HDMI port, so if you had like a Blu-ray player or something you wanted to bring with you, it will play on the television. Below that, you've got pretty good storage as well. And again, they continue with the whitewash cabinetry, which is really nice. Good roller shades on all the windows, except that front cap window will have the pleated shades, but you got a nice roller shade, slow rise on every single window. Pretty good size queen bed here as well. So in order to keep the unit short, they don't have the north-south bed. They got an east-west bed, so it keeps you nice and small. You've got good storage under it as well. You've got access to the pass-through storage on the outside. We'll point that out a little later on the outside. You got a pretty good size drawer right here. And then this is gonna be the air intake for your furnace. I like the way they keep that nice and pretty and dressed up, kind of matches the cabinetry. As we move over to the slide out, you've got a nice three-person seat. This couch will actually lay flat and kind of futon flat in case you needed the extra sleeping area. You do have a nice cup holder on each side. And for dining, you've got this folding table that sets up right in front of the couch. And then when you're done with it, it simply folds up and stores right behind the couch. Above me, you've got some really nice overhead cabinetry, again, utilizing all the space that they can in this little Geo Pro for storage for you. And as we continue around past the slide out, this is the controls for that solar panel I had mentioned earlier. So it's already got the built-in solar controller. This will just help you keep charge on the battery without overcharging the battery. Controls for your air conditioner and your heaters are right here. Excuse me, this is just actually for the heater. The controls for the air conditioner are actually on the unit itself. And it does have a 13,500 BTU air conditioner, which is about the same size you'll put on a 30-foot trailer. So that puppy will almost freeze you out of this little Geo Pro. All right, we're gonna go and check out the bathroom, but first I wanna point out one of my favorite features that they've added this year, and since they've added it, you'll probably use the bathroom a little bit more. It's the bottle opener. Crack that can right here, because they know when you're camping, you're gonna enjoy a few cold beverages. So come on into the bathroom with me, continue with the nice whitewash cabinetry into the bathroom, actual medicine cabinet over your sink, not just a mirror hanging on the wall. Nice place for your toiletries and your toothbrush as well. Above me, you're gonna have the built-in max air fan. This has got a really nice cover on it, so you can actually have it on and open while you're going down the road. It'll exhaust over 900 cubic feet of air a minute, so that really does a good job of exhausting the hot or stagnant air inside the coach. Stool right below, and then you've got a pretty nice shower. I like the enclosure that they went with this season. It's not a glass enclosure, which I think is nice because you can't really bang your elbows on a curtain, but it does still magnet shut and keep it nice and sealed in here. And then one of the other really cool features that they've got is the water miser. This is essentially a diverter valve. So when you turn your hot water on, you're not wasting all that water while you're waiting for it to get hot. This valve is actually gonna divert it back down to the water pump and hot water heater until this blue becomes translucent. You know, you got hot water, flip this little valve and boom, you're stretching out your gray tank and your fresh tank. All right, now we're gonna continue our tour of the ROCKWOOD Geo Pro 19FBS on the exterior. Little bit muddy, so bear with us as we dance around and play in the mud here. But you do have a nice, really convenient power tongue jack. Has a light on it, which is also great because you're not always hooking up or unhooking in the middle of the day. We do bring it in with the nice jacket bike rack as well for two bikes to be stored right up here on the tongue of the coach, which is going to be the most stable part of it when you're in transit. Way better than having the bike stored on the back. Nice hard cover for your 20-pound propane tanks. Does have a battery disconnect on it as well, so at the end of your trip you can flip that switch. It'll disconnect all interior power, so it's not going to drain your battery. And as we continue around, I'll point out you do have a nice pass-through storage area. I mentioned this on the inside, but here you get to see it from the outside. And look around, everything is framed out in aluminum. You don't find any wood in the ROCKWOOD Geo Pros except in the cabinetry and the 5/8 tongue and groove marine grade plywood for the decking. Right here you've got the fill spot for your fresh tank, connection for if you're at a park that had city water. You've also got an antifreeze inlet for when it's time to winterize. 6-gallon direct spark ignition hot water heater. Gas or electric, you simply flip the switch inside, no pilot light to light. As we move along here past our slide out, underneath you've got your single axle, but it's a torsion flex axle. What that means for you is there's essentially a torsion bar inside the axle, allowing independent suspension on each one of the wheels. You've got the dump for your gray, dump for your black right here at the same location. And not only are there direct heat pads on all the water tanks that are rated to keep you from freezing down to negative 11, but they do a heat wrap right here on both of your dump valves, right before the valve, because they know that's where water is also gonna tend to pool. Above that, you've got the connection for your 30-amp power cord, comes with a 25-foot shore power cord. Above that, you've got the black tank flush and an inlet for cable or satellite in case you're at a park that provides that, or if you had a portable one with you. You do have a really nice outdoor shower. This is great for rinsing yourself, the kids, the pets off. I also like to use it to rinse my dishes off. Keep a Tupperware right below it, rinse the dishes off. You don't gotta worry about all that junk in and up clogging your PEX tubes or anything. And then guess what? End of your trip, you take that bucket, pour it on the campfire, you know you're safe to roll home. As we run around the back of this, I do want to point out we bring it in with the prep for the Furion observation camera, so you can actually watch that while you're going down the road, not just while you're backing into places. And it is a full walk-on roof since it is in the ROCKWOOD line, so we bring it in with the nice ladder on the back so you can get up there once at the beginning of the season, once at the end of the season, and check all your seals. We'll continue around to the front side here. I'm going to play in the mud a little bit as we dance over to the front connection here. So we've got a really nice big power awning, comes out 8 feet. You can actually pitch it and articulate it so the water runs off one certain side, or say the sun's setting over here, you can actually tip both sides down, extend that shade a little bit more into the evening for you and your guests. Full strip of LED lights under that awning. I like the fact it's on the inside, so even with the awning in, you can utilize that light. Here are your outdoor speakers, and then right along here, is for a barbecue grill. This little rail will hold a rack that the barbecue slides on and a prep table that hooks on right by it. And I also want to mention, because I haven't pointed it out yet, this guy has got renewable power because it's inverter dedicated. So you have that solar panel keeping a trickle charge on your battery, because now we have a built-in inverter. So all your 110 outlets, your entire AC system, except for your air conditioner and your microwave, will run off that 12-volt battery system. Well, thanks for taking the time to play in the mud with me here at the Great Outdoors RV Company as we check out the ROCKWOOD GeoPro 19FBS. If you have any questions, just give me a call, 970-313-4337, or send in us email at ryan@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Make sure you subscribe to our page too, so as we get new units in and we do new videos, we can put them up for you. And if you have any requests for certain videos, roof maintenance, how to work the water heater, refrigerator issues, send in those requests and we'll do what we can to provide those videos for you. Thanks, guys.